The hippocampus is part of the forebrain, and it belongs to the limbic system, plays major roles in both short-term memory and spatial navigation, along with mood and behavior. The size of a hippocampus is affected by nurturing behavior, such as licking in rodents after birth. Well-licked rats have more developed hippocampi, more synapses, and produce less of the stress hormone cortisol. One way to examine memory and spatial learning in rodents is to put them into a water Morris maze. This is a tank with water with a platform that's underneath the water that the rodent cannot see. After repeated episodes of being put in the tank, it learns to find that platform and go to it more quickly. So that's a test of learning and memory. If you are a baby rat born to a mother that licks and grooms you from birth until weaning, you do better as an adult in these tests of memory and spatial learning. But that's not all. It's not a genetic thing, because if you take a non-licker groomer baby and you give it to mother right when it's born and it's raised during that critical postnatal period, by a licker-groomer mom, they perform just like a licker-groomer baby. As well, adult rodents that are born to mothers that had prenatal stress, even though they were licker-groomers, they perform worse like a non-licker-groomer baby. So it's a combination of some genetic predispositions along with pre- and postnatal environment that has this effect on function all the way until adulthood. Licker-groomers, babies become licker groomers, and then their babies, the next generation, also are licker groomers. If you take a low licker groomer who's been raised by its own low licker grooming mother and put them in an enriched environment in childhood with more rats and more activity available, they, in fact, will become licker groomers, and then their babies will be licker groomers. As well, if you take a licker groomer and you isolate them in childhood, they'll become low licker groomers, and that will be passed to the next generation. Does this relate to what we see in humans? Well, here's one study that looks at what I think is a relevant set of information. What they did is they looked at birth weight, and it was well known that low birth weight babies go on to have high risk for smaller hippocampus and neurodevelopmental consequences that are related to that. Then they looked at parent bonding inventory, and then of this group of women, they did MRIs to look at the size of hippocampus. So they did this in adult women and then went back and got history of the quality of bonding and care in early infancy. The women that were born at low birth weight and had a low parent bonding inventory were the ones, in fact, that had a smaller hippocampus. So it's a combination of those two factors. And this emphasizes that the postnatal environment can modulate the neurodevelopmental consequences of an already existing prenatal risk, in other words, low birth weight.